There are special crafts that can add a sparkle for moments with family and close friends. This is one of them. A metal sweets container for afternoon tea. This fashionable champagne cooler helps decorate a special night. The design is sophisticated and at the same time has the warmth of wood. These items were made by traditional craftspeople. Today, the younger generation artisans face the challenge of updating their creations while inheriting traditional skills to make beautiful items.
この1200年間先人たちが紡いできた美のバトンというものを今アップデートして未来につないでいく、ここが一つの使命になるかなと思いますので、
やっぱり人ってつながりたいと思っていると思うんですね。でもそのための共通言語、それの一つが工芸とかものづくりっていうこともあり得ると思うんですね。
Kyoto has a 1200 year history and it's the birthplace of many of Japan's beautiful crafts. Traditional techniques used to make these appealing items have had local and global impact. We followed expert craftspeople in Kyoto who are making innovations to their creations so that they can bring change to people's daily lives. Traditional crafts are said to symbolize Japanese culture.Experts in Kyoto with various backgrounds have formed a team called Go On. They want to pass on their crafts to future generations. There are six members. Hoso Masataka specializes in Nishijin Ori silk fabrics.Yagi Takahiro creates traditional metal tea caddies. Kosuga Tatsuyuki produces bamboo crafts. Tsuji Toru produces wire mesh for cooking ware. Nakagawa Shuji is a wooden basin craftsman. And Matsubayashi Hosai is a Japanese teaware potter.They are all in their 40s and 50s. There is a reason why the six people working in their respective fields join hands.
伝統産業も西洋産業で、今でこそ少し伝統工芸で少し光を当たっているもの、それも光すらも当たってなかった。そこの部分からやっぱりその世の中の固定観念を壊していこうっていうことで始めたようなプロジェクトですけど、ゴーンの、ね、名前がもう本当にそれを表してるのかなと思うんです。ゴーンっていうのは日本語の漢字のゴーンで、恩義のゴーン、これは本当に過去の今までバトンを受け継いできた過去の先人たちへのリスペクトの部分のゴーンですし、一方で英語のゴーンですね、ゴーイングオンのゴーン、両方の意味があって、これは本当にグローバルに未来に向けて、拡散していくといいますか。
Go On was formed in 2012. In Kyoto, there's anxiety among craftspeople over how traditional lifestyles would end and crafted tools used in daily lives would disappear. The Kaikado is attempting to end this trend. Their products are made to appeal to today's customers.It was founded in 1875. Beautiful metal containers using tin, brass, and copper are used to create caddies for putting in tea leaves. Almost every household in Japan once had tea caddies. The beautiful shine is all created by hand. Yagi Takahiro inherited the traditional techniques from his ancestors. He is Kaikaro's sixth generation successor. Yagi relies only on the senses of his hands. The product is made with accuracy of less than 0.1 millimeters.
これね、まっすぐなんですね。で、ここに入るんですけど、ここに膨らみをつける。内側を叩いて、ここに膨らみをつけて、蓋がこう下がってきたときに、空気に入らないように。
It's crafted so that the air is kept outside, keeping the tea leaves fresh. When you place a lid on top, it slides down silently. Sales of caddies have been on a downward trend despite its beauty and delicate construction.The custom of making and drinking tea in Japan has been gradually disappearing, and the tea caddy itself has lost its luster. Yagi took over the business from his father in 2000. He wants to bring change to this situation. Yagi found one way was to sell his products overseas.He visited London with a selection of his tea caddies. He believed Londoners highly valued their teaware and therefore could understand his products. Yagi was right. Many asked where they could buy his tea caddies. They soon became a hit product in London.This experience led Yagi to make innovations so the items could be used in other ways.
入れ物でも用途を変えればちょっとした変化でこれに使ってみたい、あれに使ってみたい。で、世界中の人がうちの缶を使って自分の大事なものを入れてもらえる、そんなものになればいいかなっていうふうに思っていてて。
These non-conventional products were added to the collection.They are pasta and nut containers. This is a metal sweets container for afternoon tea. And as for this one, when you open the lid, it's a wireless speaker. Yagi's ideas have captured the hearts of many people all over the world.His tea caddy has become a part of the permanent collection at the Victoria and Albert Museum in the UK, one of the leading museums of art and design. There is a fan of Yagi's tea caddy who is fascinated with its beauty.She is Tina from Switzerland, currently living in Japan. She puts tea leaves and coffee in four caddies.
I really love it because it just feels, I don't know, it just like kind of calms you down when you touch it. And then you also can feel the vacuum of the tea caddy and smell the really fresh coffee every morning.Which is really great because we usually grind it right before we use it. And the tea caddy really、like enhances that experience of pouring and making myself coffee as well.
The traditionally crafted items made in Kyoto is helping to create an enjoyable coffee break.It brings a couple a moment of calm and an invaluable experience. Yagi believes traditional crafts add color to everyday life. That feeling is shared by an individual whose workshop is near Kyoto on the shores of Lake Biwa. Nakagawa Shuji is a wood craftsman. Nakagawa has been making basins using traditional techniques from 700 years ago. He assembles wooden boards without using any adhesives. The boards are assembled with no gaps. It's finished so not even a drop of water leaks out. In Japan, wooden basins were used in daily life, such as when bathing or storing miso paste. However, from the latter half of the 20th century, inexpensive plastics have replaced wooden products. Yet Nakagawa saw new possibilities in using wood.
便利さだけを追求すると、それこそプラスチックの桶とかの方が便利なんかもしれないですけどね。でもその物事には結構機能だけではなくて、それ以外のこうなんていうかな、心のそのね、ゆとりや安らぎみたいなものも結構影響するんやろうなと思いますね。
He started to imagine if it was possible to make a new type of basin that has the warmth of wood. Nakagawa created this product. Curves are featured so that it would have a unique design, and its use is totally original. Nakagawa's wooden basin was reborn into a champagne cooler for high-end restaurants. The wood adds flavor to a special bottle of champagne. Dom Pérignon has even adopted it as one of its official items.
伝統的な型にを基準にしつつ、そこにデザインというものを加えていくことによって、今までなかった可能性がガッと広がるんやっていうことに気づいた。
Kimono can be said to be a symbol of Japanese beauty, yet it is also facing a drop in popularity.Nishijin Ori, made in Kyoto, is famous for being one of the finest silk fabrics used in premium kimonos. It was once the dream of Japanese women, with its abundant use of threads interwoven with gold sheets. Nishijin Ori has existed for hundreds of years.But sales have dropped as Japanese people no longer wear kimonos on a regular basis. Shipments have fallen to 1/20th in the last 30 years. Hosō Masataka, the 12th generation successor of Nishijin Ori Hosō, wanted to put a stop to this slide.
で、私自身はその西陣織を海外展開していく。これやっぱやってみたいっていうことがありまして、やっぱり今まで着物のマーケットっていうところに限定されてたのがですね、いわゆる世界中の、これはまあインテリア、ファッション、アート、テクノロジー、さまざまな分野にそれが展開できるんだなと。
Hosō has been trying to change the image of Nishijin Ori。
ちょっとこの中になりますね。今回新作のテキスタイル、見る角度だったりによって色が変わったり変化してくる。これもやっぱりこの 立体構造を織物で作って、その角度によって金の箔と銀の箔を置き換えることによって金と銀が移り変わっていくという。
Innovative and beautiful fabrics interwoven with gold are being created. It all comes from Nishijinori's weaving technology. This is what was created from the fabrics. Famous brand suits and dresses debuted at the Paris Fashion Week. The gorgeous outfit makes full use of the craft skills of Kyoto. Hosō also started working on weaving technologies. He improved his loom, previously only capable of weaving fabric about 30 centimeters wide, making it possible of weaving 150 centimeters wide. This has resulted in new uses for Nishijinori fabric, such as decorating walls. Hosō is continuing to seek possibilities for the fabrics using the latest science and technologies. Unorthodox materials are being developed in collaboration with universities and companies. This is a silk thread that changes color when exposed to heat. Hosō says it is necessary to think beyond conventional wisdom and actively seek new uses for crafts.
伝統の強さっていうのは、やっぱ壊そうとも壊れない強さがありまして、まあ、これからもどんどん新しい挑戦っていうのをし続けながら自分たちを変化し続けていく、まあ、そういうふうに考えています。
The Go On members' pursuit of new possibilities in traditional crafts is gradually gaining momentum in Kyoto. Changes can be seen in this high-end hotelThe main dining area uses elements of both Japanese and Western designs. This is the hotel's signature hamburger. The plate and bowl is from the Asahiyaki pottery, a maker of traditional teaware. Potter Matsubayashi Hosai is a member of Go-On and the 16th generation successor of his kiln. Asahiyaki teaware has been cherished for 400 years. All of the plates at this restaurant come from this top pottery maker in Kyoto. The Asahiyaki products are meant to add flavor to the dishesAnd enhance the dining experience.
わっ、綺麗とかすごいとか、やっぱりこうそういう感動みたいなものがないと、その古い文化とか新しい文化とかで関わらず自分が興味を持つことってないと思うんですよね。心を動かすっていうところをまず最初にしたいなっていうのは思いますね。
You can also enjoy Kyoto's traditional crafts in this hotel's suite rooms. This special room comes with products made by Go-On members. Here is an Asahiyaki tea bowl, along with a wooden tea container and bamboo tea ceremony tools.The hotel's general manager sees the positive effects from this collaboration.
The members of Go-On, they have this shared belief that they want to sort of take their craft into a modern setting or in a more, they challenge the status quo maybe a bit more than others would. And we were particularly, sort of interested to work with such individuals that share like the belief at Park Hyatt that we take tradition into a modern setting, combining history, heritage, and today's world.
Goan's endeavors were just starting to bear fruit, but 2020 put a sudden damper on their efforts. Tourists disappeared from the town due to the coronavirus. The big question was how Kyoto's traditional crafts were going to be introduced globally. Members held many discussions. And they decided to use social media networks to spread the word.
As a last?
Oh, that's, well, please, no, now you showed it. Tell us about that. That one is beautiful. That's urushi, right?
Yeah, this is urushi with a lacquer and kind of the transparent urushi.
Mm.
And also, this is the caddy for nuts.
Oh, for peanuts and stuff, right.
A Taiwanese fan of Goan products uploaded a photo of a toast made with Tsuji's mesh craft. A Finnish fan uploaded a photo and description of Kosuga's bamboo basket. Word of mouth on social media is increasing Goan fans globally. Hidea is a fan in Japan. He is an art director. He frequently posts items that adds value to his life. He often introduces new crafts made by Goan members.
今のものと、今の住宅もそうだし、今のいわゆる食器とか、生活するものと基本的には合うようになっているっていうのがやっぱり素晴らしい。で、その上でやっぱりかなり贅沢なものだと思うので、長く愛せるものなんじゃないかなというふうにいつも思ってます。はい。
The number of people who support Goan's activities is steadily increasing through social media. Spring has arrived in 2021. Goan members were planning for the coming future. Goan crafts continue to be updated and introduced to the world. They wanted to have their latest products to be known by more people in Kyoto. So they invited several leading figures in town to share their respective thoughts and challenges. Nakagawa presented his latest sake cups. He kept the appearance of a cut tree to express roughness and beauty at the same time.
そうですよね。あの、荒々しさであったり、その、自然そのものが美しいんではなくて、そこからこう切り取ってくるっていうか、そういうことを、そういう行為が美しさなんじゃないかなっていうふうに思ってる。これはだからまあそれこそ作家の美意識と使う側の美意識が試されるわけですよね。そうですね。
The next presentation is by wire mesh craftsman Tsuji Toru. Tsuji showed a new way in using his product adjusted to today's lifestyle. His item is specifically made for an IH induction cooker.
アミが熱せられるので、アミが熱せられた後がパンにつくっていう。で、腐熱って調べていくと、鉄の分厚さと比例するんですよね。だから鉄が分厚くなればなるほど美味しく焼けるんですよ。
These crafts have never been made before, and their uses are also new. Kosuga Tatsuyuki produces bamboo items. He introduced the culture of product maintenance. He explains restoration plays an important role in today's world.
こんだけその便利な世の中になって基本的に不便さって感じないじゃないですか。だから今後の時代に何を人間としてこう得ていくかっていうと、やっぱりそういうなんか満足度とかそういうのってすごく大きいと思うんですね。だからそれの媒体がその工芸品っていうのが今後まあ工芸の社会に対しての一つの価値じゃないかなと思います。
そうですね。
はい。
Did the guests feel the craftsman's passion behind their works?
楽しい。恩子自身というか、まさにこのやってきたことがまた今後の工芸の未来に、まあ、どうつながっていくんだろうっていうのはすごく、まあ、自分の心の中でまたこう、まあ、響いてきてた。
工芸がメディアになって、それで皆さんと意見交換をしていって、継続的にクリエイティブなこの場がね生まれていくということになれば素晴らしいなと思ってて。
It was a fruitful experience for the Go-On members and a step forward.
Go-On がずっとそれは今まで一貫しているのは、これからの未来のために自分たちは作ってるんだと。これがある未来の方が、これがない未来より絶対豊かな世界だと。
ものづくりを介して人と人とかつながっていくことっていうことが一番まず大事なことなんだなと思うんですね。それは僕たちの前の世代と僕たちの次の世代がつながることもそうだし、横につながっていくこともそうだし、そういうことの核となれるのがご恩であれば嬉しいなと僕は思ってます。
What would an abundant life in the world 50 to 100 years from now look like? It may come from the innovations born from challenges made by these new generation traditional craftspeople. This program was made possible by the Japan Foundation.